day after all of the festivities, the game, the boys' championship game, and Kiki's birthday festivities. But today is Sunday, so now we have the Kiki's banquet, her volleyball banquet to go to. So that is what everyone is getting ready for. I just got out of the shower, got dressed. I brought my makeup with me. I planned on doing like a light beat, but I think I'm gonna do an even lighter beat. So I'm a finesse something, cause I'm tired, everybody's tired. I knocked out early last night, so I'm gonna go ahead, cause it's 10:13. I'm gonna go ahead and finish, because I already started. I did my eyebrows already, mostly. I didn't carve them out. I just kind of filled them in a little bit. I need to put y'all on a tripod, because, yeah. So, get y'all together. I have to get one of the kids off to work by 11 o'clock, so I need to be done in like 15 minutes. If I can do that, I still need to pack my stuff back up, so I'm trying to hurry. Let's see what the lighting looks like. For this, y'all might not be able to see me. Oh, let's see. So, I'll probably speed this part up. At least y'all can see me. Like I said, I kind of need to hurry up. So. My makeup brushes are dirty, so that is fun. Which is another reason why I really don't want to do a full makeup look. Because I got like two breakouts yesterday. I'm like, I don't know where the hell those came from.
Oh, you good.
Hey y'all, we here. Ooh, I'm trying to show y'all my outfit, but I let my camera fall. Give y'all the OOTD. Let's see. Mm. You wanna, can you,
What you want to take a picture?
No, I want you to, it's recorded, I just want you to hold it. I can show my outfit.
I'm not thinking about it like that, but I'm thinking about it like that.
Dress from Goodwill, boots from Walmart, body from my mama. Okay. My hair acting up though. We here, y'all. We here. They doing it downtown at one of the hotels, in one of the rooms in the hotel. So this is my only battery. So I will pick that back up when we get in there. Hopefully the lighting is good as it is out here right now. So. Really? A sign seat. Hi, Ann.
Hello.
I chose happiness and I chose to be perfect. And I'm trying to do my
You ain't the only one. A lot of people look. Oh, this battery dead too.
Amen.
I got plugged up before everything gets started. We'll be back. Hopefully.
Way better.
I probably this couldn't hotel. Hit, but hopefully we'll be back.
I know change isn't always easy, but I'm super proud of them for how they bought into what we asked them to do, from crazy conditioning sessions with Savoy over the hot summer to just dealing with all the COVID stuff, having to just change lineups all the time. I mean, they dealt with it really well. I'm glad we are actually kind of back to somewhat normalcy this year versus what we went through last year. So, but overall, I feel like the improvement that they showed on the floor from the beginning to the end was second to none. I can't tell you how many like compliments we got from refs, from other coaches, parents, just, and that all goes to credit to them. I mean, they put in the work and they just wanted to get better. I did build a very tough schedule. I think they were a little upset with us for that, but it just makes them better in the long run. And I think, you know, their confidence level, especially like playing manual, you know, doing, putting up so many points against them and just the confidence level as a whole grew, and it goes to show like just how hard they worked all year. So we do have just a few awards to give out for the year. So we're going to start with the Offensive Player of the Year. This... Yes, it is Miss Trinity. She did finish with 200 kills on the season, which is huge.
Yeah.
And for the fact that we literally, like, she would look at sometimes Mariah and be like, set somebody else. Like, she was just exhausted, but we just, I mean, we knew we could count on her. Playing as an outside, as a lefty, it's hard for a lefty to do, but she fit into the role. I mean, anywhere we needed her to hit from, she would do it. So our Offensive Player of the Year is Miss Trinity Edison. All right, now we'll move to our Defensive Player of the Year.
You don't
want
to give a speech?
You want to give a speech, Trinity? No. You don't. All right, our Defensive Player of the Year, I'm super hard on this kid because I know she can be the player that I know that I want her to be. Finished with 136 digs as our libero, Miss Jasmine Morgan. She also played on the East-West All Junior Senior All-Star team. Played awesome too, so I'm looking forward to having, well, both of them come back next year as well. So, Defensive Player of the Year, Miss Jasmine. All right, now we'll go to our best blocker. Coming from a kid who just, she's so athletic. Like, she's, I'd like to say she's a freak. Like, she plays the game so aggressive, and it's like, it doesn't even, like, phase her just how much of a difference she makes for our team when she's up front. She finished with just 28 stuff blocks, but I can't tell you how many. The manual game, I think, sticks out to me the most when she had 10 in our last game. And the coach literally looked at his players and was like, she's a huge blocker in the middle. Like, we got to do something else. Like, keep it away from her. So our best blocker goes to Miss Destiny Jones.
Yeah!
You're a little toast. All right. I always like to give a hustle award away because my biggest thing is I always want them to give me 110%. So I give a hustle award away for a kid who's like literally going balls to the wall, like through the bleachers, wherever a ball's going, like. This kid's gonna be there, bringing that ball back into play. And that's Miss Kira Bartlett. I can't tell you how many just coaches and stuff are like, oh my gosh, like the energy she brings to the floor, just her presence on the floor. She's, I mean, always literally hustling. Like, so. Anyway. Wanna give a speech?
So thankful to be on the team.
All right, now we're going to move to our most improved. We did give three away just because we have, I mean, all these kids have improved, but three that really stuck out to us. So our first one, it's probably like the first week of practice. I hear, passing's so boring. And I'm like, well, we can't play the game if we can't pass. And she's like, but it's boring. The kid, like, I can't tell you how much she improved from the beginning to the end. I mean, she was, again, like the manual game just stuck up out to me. Like any of the touches on the off the blocks, like Kiki's right there to just dig it up. I mean, she had incredible ups. Now, one thing that we were working on was the talk, the communication part. And she's like, well, why can't people just assume it's mine? Like, I'm just going to take it. And it got to that point to where she was just, I mean, she was always there because she probably hears me in her sleep, like, go, just play, just go. So our first most improved goes to Miss Kiki Hamilton.
Yeah!
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. Our next most improved, defensively, she made a huge difference when she was on the floor. If Destiny wasn't up front, this was our other middle that was always a huge block. Offensively, we're working on it. So our second most improved goes to Miss Ednaya. All right, and our third most improved is another defensive specialist. I could always count on her to come in and serve. And she wanted to learn. She's always asking questions to get better. If she made a huge play, like just like the glow in her face, she's like, did you see that? I did that. So our third most improved goes to Miss Julie.
Y'all want a speech
for me.
Yeah. Oh, bro.
Okay.
Lord.
So, no, I'm just kidding. So, I just want to say thank you to the team and to the coaches for always staying on me, even though, you know, I get mad really easily if I mess up. But
it's okay.
Yeah, it was a good season. It was nice playing with y'all. Yeah. Thank you. All right. Our next award is the Yellow Jacket Award or the Coaches Award. We give this award to a player who exemplifies the quality we value as a program. Dedication, integrity, respect, responsibility, and sportsmanship. I can tell you that this kid is probably one of the best teammates that I've ever coached, and I've been coaching for 10 years. I mean, no matter what she was on the floor, off the floor, wherever we were, like, she's always a good teammate. You can always count on her to pick you up, and I mean, I didn't see her down much, but she, even if she was, like, she's still, like, trying to pick up the team. So our Yellow Jacket Award goes to Miss Riri. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. We have to do those Outstanding Player Awards. So I feel like one couldn't do the job without the other one. So our first Most Outstanding Player had 47 digs, 33 aces, 9 blocks, was named to the All-District team, and finished with 244 assists. So our first Most Outstanding Player is Mariah. Yeah. And she also, for her senior year, does earn her varsity letter from Central. And then our last Most Outstanding Player, we already talked about, had 200 kills on the year, 133 digs, 27 aces, 9 blocks, and she also played on the junior senior all-star team, Miss Trinity Edison. I think the most fun about this whole thing is that, well, unless Mariah decides she wants to come back for her fifth year, everybody's coming back, so we could just continue to build on where we left off. So again, thank you all for everything, your support, help, whatever that you all helped us tremendously with. It plays a big difference because coaching and doing all the COVID stuff, like it's a lot. So, but thanks for coming. It was a really good turnout. Everybody came. I'm excited about that. So, enjoy your holidays, and unless you have anything else. I do want to get a group picture. Don't leave. I don't know if we want to go in front of that tree downstairs or what, but. Huh?
The tree?
Where do you? What? Huh? Yeah. There's like a Christmas tree like in the lobby, I think. Yeah. I do want a group picture of all the girls. So, anyways, that's all I have for you guys.
Thank you.
I don't know what happened to my hair. It's supposed to be over here.
I got to roll. I got places to go.
You gotta go get my bag from the car.
Oh man, my phone won't recognize me. There we go.
Can you take that picture?
I did say downstairs. She's taking pictures with the
phone.
Okay,
grandma. I can't hold.
Okay, now I'm gonna take a picture of Shadow.
Y'all flat?
Yeah.
Y'all flat?
Yeah.
Not the.
Y'all want the bottle?
Oh,
we got the table with the bottle.
Wow.
What is?
What is?
I got one standing in front of the mirror.
I need the mirror.
What is it?
Why should Mona's Kiki not have the red one? You
have
the
I have it.
Dang, Kiki.
Anything else on your right? I'm not.
Okay.
Kiki, can't nobody see you. Yes, why you ain't got your medal?
Right, that's why we're here.
I'm tired. The coach is probably waiting for all y'all down there. The hotel?
Yeah, we were right there.
Oh, 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 the.
Alright.
Is she really rushing us?
Mariah,
how you
doing? I'm slow.
Here, hold it. Thanks. No.
Money, where the money at?
Money's in the bear. The money's in the bear.
Take a picture on the steps.
I'm going to take a picture. Excuse me, I got to come through because I'm going to take a picture too. Oh, don't fall. Ooh, 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 I didn't fall. Ooh. I need one too without the heads.
Okay.